And now we'd like to welcome Tim Crawley from the Rochester Museum and Science Center.
Hey guys, good to see you.
What do you have for us today?
Well, today we're going to have water taketh away and water giveth.
Okay.
It's going to be superheated steam. And I'll show you what I mean by the taketh away part first.
All right. You know, Tim, this looks like on the Discovery Channel where we see those guys in the backwoods making their own liquor, you know?
That's my next career.
Okay.
So we'll light the match, and you take a look, you can blow the match out, but instead what we can do is also put it out with the water.
Right.
Water take it away, but let's see if we can make the water give it. What I've got is my little still set up, so to speak, and it's our Erlenmeyer flask, and I've got this copper tubing that goes around. I've got the water on the boil right now, as you were working with before. The water's boiling at 100 degrees C or 212 degrees Fahrenheit, and that's making, let's see if we can see it a little bit better, put it back.
Oh, we certainly see all the steam.
See all the steam coming out. Mm-hmm. It is condensation. It actually is, when you look at it, it's not vapor. It's basically fog.
Oh, wow.
It's just like clouds.
Okay.
So right now, if we take that, I'll put my goggles on, and we'll put a match to that.
Well, nothing happens.
Nothing. Okay. And nothing's going to happen with that. But what we're talking about is superheated steam.
Okay.
So what we're going to do...
Got some fire there.
...is superheat some steam. We're going to take this map gas. It'll spit out a little bit of water to begin with. And after we heat up the coils... And copper is a really good conductor of both electricity and heat because of that lattice work of the ions and the free electrons that are inside of it. As we work it out, when we heat it up a little bit more, we should be able to see
condensation or steam out there anymore.
You don't see the steam coming out. Now that vapor is superheated. Okay. That vapor is coming out there somewhere around about 400 degrees Fahrenheit, about 200 degrees C. Now let's see if we can get this to work this time for us.
Wow, okay.
So there you go.
Hot enough to light your match. So
hot enough to light the match. It gets to there now. We said, water take it. We got.
And then you put our goggles on here.
Well, you can if somebody wants to hold the.
Oh, yeah. It's starting to char the paper.
Yeah. We'll get it a little bit more, see if we can't get it to.
Yep, starting to char pretty good there.
Yep, it gets it pretty well.
Charred pretty good
so
there.
So it's actually really hot.
Yep.
It's coming out right now, as we said before. Let's see if we can take...
I got my gargles, so I'm ready.
All right, so you can do it.
So what am I doing here?
In another second, leave it all stretched out and get ready to put it against there and get ready just to let it go.
And I... Gone.
It's flash paper. It's basically.
How long did you do this? Wow, very good.
So it's magician's paper.
Magician's paper.
That's what it's doing right now. Is it superheats that steam, and that's where you get a lot of energy. This is one thing where firemen have to be very careful when they're going into a building that's burning. You turn around and you're using the water to put out the fire, but it's also that fire is so hot, it's making that superheated steam.
Okay.
And it can push it out there and bring that up to 400 plus degrees.
Way higher than
what you want.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, great, Tim, great job.
Yeah, you know, very cool.
We'll have to have another lesson where we talk about the whole idea of distilling things.
Distill wood.
Yeah.
That way, nothing wrong with that.
All right, now we'd like to thank Tim for being here tonight. But to learn more about the Rochester Museum and Science Center, head to our website, homeworkhotline.org. But stay right there. We'll be back in just a second.
Thanks, Tim.